Hello friends, today we are going to study another important topic on chemistry, that is why carbon forms only covalent bonds and why do such a large number of carbon compounds exist in nature. So coming to the first question, why carbon forms only covalent bonds? The atomic number of carbon being 6, the configuration is 2, 4. Now, having 4 electrons in the outermost shell means that carbon, it shows a valency of 4. It has the tendency to gain 4 electrons or to lose 4 electrons or to share 4 electrons. These are the 3 possibilities that are there. Taking the first possibility in mind, that is gaining 4 electrons. Suppose carbon shows the tendency of gaining 4 electrons. This means that carbon will form C4 negative ion if it gains the first electron. It forms C negative, gaining the second electron becomes C2 negative, finally C3 negative and C4 negative are or will be formed. Now, is this possible? We all know that like charges, they repel each other. So adding an electron to a negatively charged ion is very difficult. We may imagine C2 negative might be formed, CO, just in the way O2 negative exists. But adding negative to 2 negative is all the more difficult, and adding negative to 3 negative is even more difficult. So a large amount of energy is required for this, which makes this C4 negative highly unstable. So this does not exist actually. So the first possibility of gaining 4 electrons is ruled out. Now coming to the second possibility, that is losing 4 electrons. If carbon loses 4 electrons, the ion that will be formed will be C4 positive. Because when the first electron will be lost, it will form C positive. C positive on losing another electron will form C2 positive. Finally, C3 positive and C4 positive will be formed on losing of the third electron and the fourth electron respectively. Again, like charges, they repel. So unlike charges, they attract each other. In this case, we are trying to remove a negative charge from a positive charge, while the two, they have a tendency of attraction. So for removing electron from a positively charged ion, a large amount of energy is required, which makes C4 positive again highly unstable. So this possibility is also ruled out. Now the third possibility is that of sharing electrons. Sharing electrons is feasible because in that case no charges are involved. And it is easy because carbon, it has 4 electrons in its outermost shell. If some monovalent atom such as hydrogen comes close to it, the monovalent atom is also benefited because its duplet becomes complete. And carbon itself is also benefited because its octet is now complete. So in this way, carbon, it forms 4 bonds with hydrogen, and the structure that I have made is of methane. So in this way, carbon, it forms covalent bonds. So the first question, I hope it's clear now, why carbon forms only covalent bonds? Because carbon doesn't form C4 negative, it doesn't form C4 positive. So the only possibility that is left in order to be stable is by sharing electrons. That is why carbon forms only covalent bonds. Now, coming to the second question, that is, why do such a large number of carbon compounds exist in nature? The answer lies in 3 different points. The first point is small size. Since in carbon, only 2 shells are involved. First shell, that is K shell, and the second shell, that is L shell. The size of carbon atom is very small. So whichever bond it forms, the electrons are held very near the nucleus and the Force of attraction of the nucleus makes the bond stronger. The second property is tetravalency. As we saw here, carbon has 4 electrons in its outermost shell. So it has the property of sharing those 4 electrons, which result in the formation of 4 bonds. Tetra means 4, valency means 4, because it has a valency of 4. So carbon forms 4 bonds. It is not necessary that the bonds are always single bonds. They may be double bonds or they may be triple bonds also. But in all, carbon always forms 4 bonds. This is the second property which enables the existence of a large number of carbon compounds in nature. The third property and the most important property is catenation. The word catenation means the linking ability of carbon atoms. Carbon has the unique property of linking with itself or with other monovalent atoms to form long chains, rings, branch chains, and many other different structures. So a compound having the same molecular formula, like if we take the example of pentane over here with the formula C5H12, we can see it forms different structures. Like in this case, this is normal pentane. Each line that I am drawing represents a bond with hydrogen, a single bond with hydrogen. This is one structure of pentane. Then if we make one branch, this is the second structure of pentane. If you count the number of lines, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. The molecular formula comes out to be the same. Another way it can be arranged is like this. In this case also, the molecular formula comes out to be C5H12 only. So, in case of pentane, we can see that one molecular formula can be represented by three different structures. So, because pentane is a very small molecule, you can imagine carbon forms compounds having 100 or even more number of atoms. How many different arrangements can be possible for them? So, this property of carbon is known as catenation. It can link with itself as well as it can link with other atoms such as hydrogen to form different types of structures. It may be in the form of chains, it may be in the form of rings, or it may be in the form of branches. So to recapitulate, carbon forms a wide number of compounds in nature because of three possible reasons, that is small size, tetravalency, and catenation. These two questions that we have discussed in this video are very important. You can expect this question and as well as this question of 3 marks weightage in your board exams. And if you like the videos, don't forget to share and subscribe. Keep watching.